Hello students, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to start the subtopic second phase of the Moamaria Rebellion, third phase of the Moamaria Rebellion and ultimately British invasion. Okay, so in this topic we will discuss what happened in the second phase of the Moamaria Rebellion. In the last class we have discussed how the first phase ended, okay, how the atrocities of Kirtisandra Barbarua, okay, during the reign of Lakshmi Singha, how the Moamarias attacked them, okay, took revenge upon them. So in that way, later on in the second phase also, the Moamarias, they were still having the desire to take revenge, okay. So during the reign of Gorinath Singha, okay, Gorinath Singha, who is Gorinath Singha? He is the son of Lakshmi Singha. Okay, Lakshmi Singha's son is Gorinath Singha. Okay, during the reign of Gorinath Singha, what happened? The Moamarias, they marched towards the capital. Okay, they first tried to attack the king, they marched towards the capital. Okay, Ahom capital, but the Moamarias could not totally attack them because during that time Ghanashyam, the Buragohai, okay, the minister of Gorinath Singha, Ghanashyam Buragohai, he has taken some good measures due to which the Moamarias could not attack. Okay, so they were chased back from Rangpur itself. Okay, they came up to Rangpur, but from Rangpur itself they were chased back. Okay, so as a result of this, Gorinath Singha, he had some unspeakable measures, okay, upon the Moamarias. Okay, he had ordered his men that they should commit atrocities upon the Moamarias. Upon whom? Upon the Moamarias. Okay, so as a result, what happened? These atrocities were so much unbearable, okay, that Gorinath Singha made these Moamarias to run away, or to compel to run away to the neighboring areas, those Kachari kingdom, okay, Jayantia, Kachari and Jayantia kingdoms. Okay, they were compelled to run away to these neighboring areas. Okay, so as a result, what happened? Ahom kingdom, okay, where most of the people were from these satras, were of this Moamaria side, most of the Ahom kingdom was depopulated. So in this way the second phase came to an end, but Moamaria rebellion still, the discontent of taking revenge against the Ahom kingdom, okay, taking revenge, okay, to dethrone the Ahom kingdom, the Moamarias were still having that discontent. So that is why the third phase of the rebellion took place. So as a result, the Moamarias were also, now they were thinking that the Ahom king has made so much atrocities upon them, now they were also thinking that they should now come up with some good measures, okay, good plan to attack the Ahoms again. Now let us see what was the plan in the third phase of the rebellion. So this third phase, as the Moamarias were already so much ready to take revenge, their desire was so much alive, they got the opportunity when? In the year 1786. So in 1786, they joined hand with Dafala Bhatias. Okay, so who were these? They were also a hill tribe, okay, neighboring hill tribe. So Moamarias joined hand with Dafala Bhatias. Okay, Dafala Bhatias, actually these Dafala Bhatias, they were subdued or a policy was made with them by the Ahom ruler. Okay, they used to be the subordinates of the Ahoms. Okay, so the Fala Bhatiyas were subdued, and the Fala Bhatiyas were joining hands with the Moamoriya. Now what? Moamoriya will be a stronger group to fight against the Ahoms. Okay, so by this time what happened, as the Moamoriyas were joining hand with the Fala Bhatiyas, by this time what happened, Gorinath Singha, okay, already he tried to defend his kingdom, but what happened, this group, they defeated the royal army. Okay, they defeated the royal army, and that is why Gorinath Singha he fled to where? Guwahati. That means he left his capital and fled to Guwahati. That time, this is the spelling. Okay, that is why what happened, the Moamoriyas again captured the capital. As this happened, the king himself flew away to Guwahati. What happened, the Moamoriyas captured the capital. But this time, do you think they could, like the last time in the first phase of the rebellion, do you think this time they could rule here, or they could successfully establish their man here? So we will see this one here. So in the meantime, as the Moamoriyas captured the capital, they established their Mahanta. Mahanta means, you know, the satradhikar. Mahanta Bharat Singha, okay, on the Ahom throne. That means on the throne where the Ahom were ruling, okay, Bharat Singha. But in this meantime, the Ahom administrative system, okay, it has already changed. The Boragohai changed here, okay. Earlier, who was the Boragohai of Gorinath Singha? He was Ghanasyam Boragohai. Here, his son, okay, Ghanasyam Boragohai's son, we will see here, son, what is his name? Lari Gohai. Okay, Lari Gohai, he became the Boragohai. Okay, so this Lari Gohai, I think you know, many of us, everyone of us know as Purnananda Boragohai. He is famous in Ahom history. Okay, Purnananda Boragohai, he is famous by this name. Lari Gohai is famous by this name. Why he is famous? He is very courageous. Okay, he has so much devotion towards his duty. Okay, how he tried to protect the Ahom kingdom from Moamoriya rebellion. This set an example of how much power or how much courageous he was. Okay, that is why Purnananda Boragohai is remembered in history in this way. So Purnananda Boragohai, he tried his best to protect the kingdom. That means whatever is left now, because already because of the Moamoriya rebellion, in the first phase, in the second phase, almost most of the parts were destroyed, or almost the Ahom kingdom, the foundation has been shaken. Okay, but Purnananda Boragohai, he tried his best up to whatever or how much he can do. Okay, for security purposes, to save himself, or for to secure the kingdom, he also flee away to Jorhat. That is why at last the Ahom capital was Jorhat. Okay, he set up the capital in Jorhat. Okay, so established Ahom capital in Jorhat, and these people, the people of the Ahom kingdom, they were actually fearing the Moamoriyas. Okay, they were actually fearing the excess atrocities of the Moamoriyas. So the people thought that here we are talking about people. Okay, the people thought that they would join the Moamorias in order to save themselves. So, but what do you think? What happened? Could they save themselves? Or Purnananda Buraguhai, see, these people who feared the Moamorias and thought that they would join the Moamorias against the Ahom and save themselves from the Moamorias, these people were again, okay, well trained by Purnananda Buraguhai. He trained them in warfare, okay, these villagers in warfare, and sent these people in battle against the Moamorias. Those people who were about to join the Moamorias, now they are going in battle against these Moamorias. Understood? So Purnananda Buraguhai, because of his leadership or his courage to train these people, the Moamoria rebellion was somehow to a great extent he could stop. Okay, so it is said that in this great time of danger, Purnananda Buraguhai had safely or very nicely controlled the kingdom. Okay, but whatever you say, because while studying the cause, we have seen that the so as we have seen the causes of Moamoria rebellion in the previous classes, we have seen that actually because of the atrocities of the Ahom rulers upon them, they were trying to take the revenge. Okay, but whoever is taking the revenge, okay, whoever's atrocity it is, be it Moamoria's atrocities or the be it atrocities of the Ahom ruler, okay, whoever was fighting, actually who is suffering here? The people, the common people had to endure great suffering here. Okay, whenever is there is a war in our land, also in the in present also, if both countries fight war, actually the common people had to suffer a lot, okay, due to this, because as people were joining the war against the Moamorias, they had to what? They had to leave their home, okay, leave their home, they had to leave the cultivation also. So as a result, what happened? The famine took place. F-A-M-I-N-E. Famine means what? A situation where there is a scarcity of food and all, okay, scarcity of food, and as a result, what will happen? The people will fall ill, okay, in this way, because of a rebellion or because of a war, the suffering was who had to suffer? The common people had to suffer. So as a result, the famine took place, and one of the more results, you can see that because of the these phases of the Moamoria rebellion, as they took revenge, the foundation of the Ahom kingdom already became weak. Okay, the foundation already became weak. Now as a result, the people, okay, the small rulers, okay, who were at one time the subordinates of the Ahoms, now they declared revolt, like the king of Darang, okay, then in Kamrup, a Chaudhary was there. Chaudhary, actually that time they collected revenue and all, okay, Kamrup Chaudhary. Chaudhary, okay, they declared revolt against whom? Against the Ahom kingdom, okay, because Ahoms were becoming weak by that time. They thought of declaring themselves independent rulers, okay, now they will no longer remain subordinates of the Ahoms, okay. So as the Ahom kingdom was becoming weak, what happened? These people, the tributary rulers, they declared revolt, and even the Satradikar or Moamoria leader, okay, Moamoria leader, his name is Sarbananda Singha, ओके सर्बानंदा सिंह ही डिक्लेयर्ड हिमसेल्फ इंडिपेंडेंट रूलरशिप व्हेन द अहोम किंगडम वाज अ स्ट्रॉन्गर वन दे कुड नॉट दे डिड नॉट हैव दिस करेज टू फाइट रिवोल्ट अगेंस्ट द रूलर और टू डिक्लेयर इंडिपेंडेंट रूलर बिकॉज दैट टाइम द अहोम किंगडम वाज स्ट्रॉन्गर देयर इकोनॉमी वाज स्ट्रॉन्गर नो वन हैड दिस करेज टू फाइट अगेंस्ट देम और what to declare independent rulers but then, now by this time what is happening Sarbananda Singha he was a Mamoreya leader he also declared himself independent ruler okay independent ruler and he minted coins minting coin is really one of a powerful symbol of a ruler okay if the even Ahom rulers had their own coins that means having coins and your coins will be circulated in this region and people will accept you as a ruler okay this minting coin is that is why adopted by the ruler as their independence or to symbolize that they are sovereign rulers okay now by this time what happened Ahom kingdom okay the because of this side revolts okay which took place taking the opportunity of the situation okay that was created by Mamoreya rebellion okay the Mamoreya rebellion situation taking this opportunity these people they declared themselves independent or they also sent revolt against started revolt against the Ahoms and as a result Ahom kingdom okay the kingdom was shattered so what will the ruler do now what will Gorenath Singha do now he was totally helpless by this time okay by this time the ruler was totally helpless and what happened Ahoms were totally helpless because now they could not fight against these powers now they were becoming weak so to save themselves okay from this political disaster danger okay to save themselves they were compelled actually they had no other options they were now compelled to beg okay for military assistance in front of the British okay the Ahoms they were compelled now because they have to save themselves from the Mamoreya rebellion they have no other choices they were compelled to beg for what military assistance okay so as a result what happened English they were already trying to get a chance to come over this northeastern region and rule here because they were already settling themselves in Bengal and these areas okay so the British they were that means they at once agreed to this request of Gorenath Singha they totally agreed and the company they what happened they send this expedition I think you know the expedition sent by British during this time under whom Captain Welch this report we will get to see in the last part of this chapter Captain Welch okay Captain Welch and it was sent in 1792 which was there up to 7 that means they stayed here up to 1794 so the British their aim was not actually to save the Ahoms they have other motives also they have other objective also because they wanted their main objective was during that time trade and to acquire as much as resources they can from India so they tried to come here and to gather information about the Ahom or entire Ahom kingdom and the entire northeast actually okay Ahom so they tried to gather information but on what condition actually they were coming the condition that Ahoms begged them was that they will come here send military assistance to fight against the Mamoreyas okay to settle all kind of disputes and re-establish them on the Ahom throne, re-establish the king on the Ahom throne. So this part of the word was not visible. This is 1792 to 1794, the Captain Wells, the expedition part we will discuss in our next class. Okay, the expedition led by Captain Thomas Wells report we will see, okay, which came to Assam. What happened after this we will see in our next classes. But taking this opportunity, British occupied or British invaded, in a way this is a invasion of British of Assam, okay, by the British of Assam. So as a result, we already know that British at last ruled in Assam also. They had settled in Assam also. So this Moamoriya rebellion actually paved the way for the British to enter Assam. Okay, so in our next class we will see how they occupied Guwahati, okay, how entire administration they had gathered information about. Okay, so in how British actually suppressed the Moamoriya rebellion in the fourth phase, we will see that. So results of the rebellion we will see in the next class. Thank you so much. We will discuss our doubts, whatever you have, in our doubt clearance class. Thank you.